Hey guys, you know, because I stand on the real gospel, 1 Corinthians 15, 1 through 4, and I stand on God's immense unconditional love and the shed blood of Christ alone to save us. Faith alone, God's grace. People always send me verses on the great white throne judgment to show me how I'm telling people to stay in their sin and they're going to pay for their sin. No, anyone in Christ, Jesus has already paid for their sin. There's no sin left to pay for. And I wanted to show you here that we're not the dead, okay? We're the living. Jesus said he's not the God of the dead. He's the God of the living. We know that Moses and Elijah showed up on the Mount of Transfiguration. They're alive. When they left his body, they were still alive. They went to be with God. All right, first of all, that's a long story. They were in Sheol, and then once Jesus died, was buried, and rose again, they all came up to the earth. They walked around Jerusalem. They were seen of many people, and then they ascended into heaven. Okay, but that's a whole other story, but it's true. Look it up yourself. All right, now, I wanted to give you this verse they always give me. Look, any person that is relying on the death, burial, and resurrection that has gotten the revelation of God's tremendous love for them, and is resting in the death, burial, and resurrection alone, they're trusting the Savior saved them. I've never seen anybody like really, really get that into their heart and just, you know, hate God and want to run out and do terrible things to people. I just don't understand it. But see, these people that don't have the full revelation of God's love, that think he died for us, but you got to do this, you got to do that, they don't have the revelation of God's love. And see, those forgiven much, love much. So, I am constantly given verses like this of condemnation and fear. And it makes me sad because I'm thinking, wow, although they're throwing them at me, hoping I'm condemned, or maybe they think they're, you know, they're helping me. It really condemns them. They must be living in so much fear to not know you have eternal life. We believe on Christ so that we know we have eternal life. I don't understand why it's so confusing for people. I did a video a minute ago, salvation, it's the gospel, it's free, it's he wants people saved. Then there's the second thing, the edifying of the church. He wants to lift them up so that God's name is magnified. And both of those columns magnify the Lord. Him saving us with no help of our own, he gets all the glory. And then us living a godly life also magnifies him. But only if the Spirit's in us, and only if we're doing it unto God, because we love him out of gratitude, not because we're doing it out of fear, trying to stay out of hell, because it doesn't save us. All right, let me give you Revelation 20:11. This is a common one people like to send to me. And I saw a great white throne, and him that sat on it, from whose face the earth and the heaven fled away, and there was found no place for them. And I saw the dead, small and great, stand before God. And the books were open, and another book was opened, which is the book of life. And the dead were judged out of those things which were written in the books according to their works. And the sea gave up the dead which were in it, and death and hell delivered up the dead which were in them, and they were judged every man according to their works. And death and hell were cast into the lake of fire. This is the second death, and whosoever was not found written in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire. Who in the world would think this has anything to do with a saved person? Now, I want to show you some scriptures here. This isn't just my opinion. I'm going to show you some verses here. I know there are some of you that do not, but I'm telling you, a ton of verses don't make sense without this doctrine being clear. I stand on it. My pastor stands on it. Many men of God stand on it. There are some kind of rewards of ruling in the millennial kingdom with Christ for being faithful now on this earth. There's the parable of the talents. There's all kinds of things. Plus, there's this very clear section in 1 Corinthians 3 that tells you that you will suffer loss of some kind of eternal reward, but you'll still be saved. All right? Now, I don't want to argue with you. I don't know. People seem to think we're still going to have this mentality, the sinful mentality. Well, that's not fair. That guy got that, and I didn't get that. No, we know that we're not going to have that. We're going to be... Everything is to magnify God. And my pastor's always saying, see, I wanna get there. I want to have my reward so I can hand them to Jesus and glorify Jesus, because I don't even belong to be there, you know? So I don't know why they think this, like, glorifies us. I don't think so. And I don't think there's anything wrong with God giving certain things to rule and reign for those that are faithful in this life. He saves us all, We all enter in the kingdom because what he did, not because of what we do. But those of us like Paul, like not us, I'm nothing. But the Paul and the apostles, they get to stand over the 12 tribes of Israel. They have some very special reward in the kingdom that Jesus rules on this earth, the millennial kingdom. And I don't want to get into that whole doctrine, but I'm just telling you, please don't send me stuff that the no, there's no such thing as a reward. The reward is here in this life. Okay, I get you. We disagree. Okay, this is not a doctrine that you and I have to agree on. We don't have to split fellowship because we don't get along on this. Only the identity of Jesus Christ, his virgin birth, who he is, God in the flesh, what he did for us, the gospel, that's our foundation. That's it. That's what should be splitting fellowship, because we don't unite in error on those things. Everything else, we should be coming to like mind on, and I stand on it. I'm sorry. I understand you don't, and I've read everything you've sent me, and I can appreciate it, but I disagree wholeheartedly. There are too many verses that make no sense if you remove his rewarding certain saints that do dedicate and are faithful to him in this life. I see no problem with it. The martyrs are rewarded. I don't see why anybody would have a problem with somebody being martyred and God rewarding them in some way. Why is that an issue? You know, because they're thinking like we're still going to have this sinful, envious, jealous. It's not like that. It's all for the glory of God. Everything glorifies him. All right. So with that being said, I'm letting you know, because I get so much of this doctrine of rewards. That's work salvation. That's it. No, it's not. We don't even deserve to be there. The foundation is the finished work of Christ alone. This is once we're saved, if we decide, as Paul, I beseech you, brethren, to present yourself a living sacrifice. If you do that and you go and you live for Christ, not yourself, there's no reason he can't reward you with being more faithful with something in the eternal realm. I don't have a problem with it. I don't know why people do. It's very clear in this verse right here I'm about to give you. I don't know how else you can understand this. So, and there are other verses like, if we deny him, he'll deny us, but it's not that we deny him and then, like, if we forever deny him, of course he'll deny us for the Father. But if you've once received him and believed in him and you've been saved, you're always saved. So what can that verse mean? If we deny him service to him, he denies us ruling for him and his kingdom. And that's exactly what that verse means if you read it in context. So when you take away this, the rewarding of faithful. Now, none of us should be boasting, I'm so faithful. Nonsense. Okay? None of it. It's everything we're doing unto the Lord. But there's nothing wrong with giving someone motivation. You know, I want to have all these things so I can put them at the feet of God. I want to get these and lay them at his feet and just let it. There's nothing with glorifying. It glorifies God. It glorifies the church. It lifts up the name of Jesus to live like this. And I'm sorry. There's too many verses, too many things that don't make sense. I understand there are some rewards and loss of them that are in this life now, like assurance, joy, fellowship. Those are things we can lose. It's not talking about this. It's talking about that day, the judgment day. Okay, here's something from Paul real quick. Let me tell you. And this is how I know we're not the dead. Okay, for to be absent from the body, it says, wherefore we labor, that whether present or absent, that we may be accepted of him. And then it says, we are confident, I say, and willing rather to be absent from the body and to be present with the Lord. See? So we're not the dead that's in hell and in death, okay? Because God is the God of the living and not the dead, all right? So we are not the dead brought up here for judgment. Now it says here, for we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, that everyone may receive the things done in his body according to that which he's done, whether it be good or bad. Now we know that every idle word will be accounted for. But no saved person resting in the finished work of Jesus has to answer for sin once they're saved, because Jesus has already taken the wrath for their sin. They just don't believe it. And then their names are written in the book of life. So we're not judged on these works anymore. Do you understand? All right, let me give you this, and I'll show you that Paul tells you this right now. All right. According to the grace of God, which is given unto me as a wise master builder. I have laid the foundation. What's that? The gospel, the finished work of Christ. And another buildeth thereon. See, he gives you the foundation that Christ died for your sins, was buried, and rose again on the third day according to scriptures. Now you're saved. You have the Holy Spirit. You've trusted in him. Trusted, okay? There's the foundation. Now you can build on it with your service to God. It tells you right now. But let every man take heed how he buildeth thereupon. I've told you, when people go and just live crazy once they're saved, take heed, because the judgment comes on the house of God. You will reap what you sow. Okay, now you're representing God's name. You're going to have some, you can't go do crazy stuff like that and think that you're just not going to have a consequence for it on this earth. Okay, and with the reward thing, you can lose ruling and reigning or whatever position you would have had. Okay, I'm showing you this here. This is not me making it up, all right? I'm sorry if you disagree with it. I don't know why, but all right. It's probably better if Belief Is Not a Work doesn't even watch this video. Please don't watch it. Just stop, okay? Because I don't want to argue with you no more. All right. Now, for other foundation can no man lay that is laid, which is Jesus Christ. Now, if any man build upon this foundation, gold, silver, precious stones, wood, hay, stubble. Now, our work is represented by gold, silver, precious stones. If it's something that glorifies God, if it remains, or if it gets burned up when it's tried by the fire of God's presence. Okay? Every man, no, it says, and if any man build upon this foundation, gold, silver, precious stone, wood, hay, stubble. Every man's work shall be made manifest, for the day shall declare it. That's the judgment day. Okay? Because it shall be revealed by fire. And the fire shall try every man's work of what sort it is. And they make fun of it and say, oh, the bonfire beam of sea. What? It tells you that right here. I don't know why people have a problem with this. I guess they're thinking it's going to be like now, where we're just, you know, thinking we're better than people. And I just don't see any of that. Everything's all glorifying God. Everything's all great. It's just, none of it bothers me. I just can't get why people have a problem with it. And what do these other verses all through scripture mean if you take out that dot? All right. Let's say it again. Let me get through this without, I get too upset because I just don't understand why people hate it so much. Every man's work shall be made manifest, for the day shall declare it, because it shall be revealed by fire, and the fire shall try every man's work, what sort it is. Here we go. If any man's work abide, which he's built thereupon, he shall receive a reward. Let me say that again. If any man's work abide, which he hath built thereupon, he shall receive a reward. If any man's work shall be burned, he shall suffer loss. But he himself shall be saved, so as by fire. Okay, so we don't lose salvation when you, depending on what you do once you're saved, you can either be glorify God with it, and he wants to reward you. I don't have a problem with it, but it says so right here. Or you can suffer loss of that. You know, he's got plans for you. He wants you to walk in these good works, and if you're doing them through some motivation to look religious or to look good, those motivations are going to be tried by the fire of God. He knows our hearts. Okay, this is not to give you fear. This is to show you that we are secure here, and we are not the ones here that are cast into the lake of fire because we're judged on our works. All right, the sin's already been taken care of. That was taken care of on the cross. So I don't know why people just keep trying to think this has something to do with save people. It's those that aren't written in the book of life. And we're written in the book of life. Okay, let me give you a couple of verses on how he gives us life. So we're not the dead. We are the living. And I give unto them eternal life. Can you get clear? John 10:28. And they shall never perish. Never, 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 never. Can people just get that? He gives it to us and we have it now. It's a present tense possession. It's not later. It's not a hope. We're not saved till we get to heaven. Somebody said, really? Then you're not saved. Salvation, part of salvation is knowing that you're saved. All right. And then, because it's blessed assurance. We'll sing Amazing Grace and Blessed Assurance and then say that nonsense. All right. They shall never perish, neither shall any man pluck them out of my hand. All right. 1 John 5:11. And this is the record that God has given to us eternal life, and this life is in his Son. I don't know why people don't understand this. Here we go. 1 John 5:13, these things have I written unto you that believe on the name of the Son of God, that you may know that you have right now eternal life, and that you may believe on the name of the Son of God. Okay, so we can know we have it. We are not the dead, we are the living. I'm sorry, there's a couple of you that just hate the rewards concept of the judgment seat. I don't know how else to explain that. Let me read one more time, because I don't want to hear it. We're standing on scripture here. If you don't like it, I don't know. I don't understand it. Every man's work shall be made manifest, for the day shall declare it. The day of judgment. Because it shall be revealed by fire, and the fire shall try every man's work of what sort it is. If any man's work abide, which he's built thereupon, he shall receive a reward. If any man's work shall be burned, he shall suffer loss, but he himself shall be saved. So as by fire. Okay, I didn't make it up. Get mad at God. Okay. All right, I just wanted to show you that, because we are not the ones at the great white throne judgment. All right? Love you. Bye-bye.